I don't know if I want to do it.
Like, it's sort of unnecessary, but I would like to get some practice. We've got to get some practice. That's about the length of Witt Road, or maybe a little shorter.
I can't see my GPS when I'm standing up. I looked down, I was like, oh, that's not right.
I saw it. Yeah, I thought there was a bridge there. The first one's on a bridge. This goes up, and there's a right-hand turn. It comes back to that first road you just saw. Yeah. That's the one that's got the bridge. Because I rode that route one time. And believe it or not, there's another way into here, too. About, well, matter of fact, you know when you pulled over and hid behind the sign? Him and me were sitting on the side of the road and you went past it just a little way.
Oh, yeah.
You come in from right there, too. I came out that way one day. Anyway. So I've been out that way. What did he lose this time?
He stopped to take a picture.
Oh, I hear you. You guys keep going. Okay.
Well, there's a... You got a turn up here, Rick, so... Well, I just want to make sure. Yeah, turn right here. Now, do we have to worry about much traffic up through here?
We might see one or two, but not like
that. I'm glad you said that, but I don't know. Keep going. I'll figure it out in a second.
Because there's so much camping and stuff right here. That what we met, 3-4 vehicles. Anyhow, that's nothing compared to what I've seen on the weekend coming through here. You can't get through there. Now here's where I met those Jeeps, but it being on a Friday, still early day, this is good trail. It's a little narrow, but it's a dirt road, not a gravel road. But it's a good one. It takes all the way up top of the mountain and we'll come down on the top of a ridge, and if I'm not mistaken, we'll turn left on Blacktop. And then the next road is 129.
Yep, Georgia 180 is where you turn left, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, let's see if I can find first. There we go.
Thank you.
to stop back there because my visor wouldn't Hey, hold on a second. I just saw something laying in the trail. I didn't get a good look, but I'm going to see. It's about the size of your tool bag. Nope, it's a piece of trash. That's that way though.
Oh, okay, let's go that way then.
Yeah. I don't want to hold you guys up. I got caught up on these corners, wasn't even paying attention.
What?
I said I got caught up on these corners and wasn't even paying attention to where the route was going.
Well, like I said, they changed it. Kept on going.
Did it?
I've often wondered where this went.
Well, that's where it's going now.
Yeah.
He said they changed it. I don't know if you can still hear it. Can you hear me? They changed this route here. He said it used to keep going down that road. He said he's always wondered where this went. I said, well, we're about to find out. Getting pretty good down through there. I think it's that same CL300 or 300L. What were you saying you were using it for diving? There's a thin strip where there's not much gravel, and I'm just trying to stay in there.
I'd love to do like a cross-country kind of thing, but not on lead bike. Look for the smallest adventure bike. It's on the, like I, you know, I told you the other day, on the has a little baby one.
You need fuel? Yeah, just go ahead and get some. Regular gas, ethanol free, but it's regular. Oh, it's 93 over there. $380. Not bad.
The other one stayed on the road that we rocked.